What's happening, y'all? This week we bending over for the man with The Handmaid's Tale by Margaret Atwood. The shit's going ham up in the USA, where a crew of Bible-thumping hunkies brought down the government, took a shit on the Constitution, and now they running the game with a new society called Gilead. And up in G-Town, the man always hating on women. They can't own property, work, learn, nothing. They just get tossed in the house and gotta do whatever they told. And since Mother Earth been f***ed by pollution, syphilis, and all kind of other mess, most women can't pop out babies no more. To keep the human race alive, some women are captured and turned into handmaids, which are basically baby-making sex slaves. This story following the life of Afred. Girl tried to bail to Canada with her fam, but she got by the fuzz and brought to the re-education center where they gonna brainwash her into a true blue handmaid. Afred eventually becomes a handmaid for some brother named Commander Fred, who she gotta get buck nasty with while laying on his wife Serena. And ain't nobody enjoying themselves at all. What Serena don't know, though, is that the Commander and Afred been chilling like she more than just his booty call. They doing the kinkiest things you can think of. Scrabble and magazine reading. Mm-mm. Afred ain't really feeling their little date nights, but she go along with it anyway. One day, Afred out shopping with a sister named Off-Glen when she like, psst, say girl, keep this on a DL, right? But I'm a member of the resistance called Mayday, and we trying to stick it to them Gilead haters. Pissed that a bitch ain't gotten preggers yet, Serena say she'll give Afred info on her long-lost daughter if she bangs the gardener Nick. Serena wanna get rid of Afred real bad. Turns out, diddling Nick's dangle is pretty sweet, and they start banging on the red. Later, Afred get word that Off-Glen offed herself because she was afraid the secret police were coming to get her. When Serena found out that Afred hit the club with her hubby, girl gets mad crunk. Not long after, two busters roll up in a van to take Afred away. But Nick say, don't trip, girl. They actually Mayday members coming to save your ass. So Afred get tossed in that van, not knowing whether she about to be freed or get wrecked. The book end with a section called Historical Notes. About two centuries later, some stuffy-ass professor talking about Gilead and the fact that The Handmaid's Tale might be a bunch of bullshit. The hell? Now, if you done peeped this text, you might be asking yourself, why the hell is this story all janky and out of order? The main character, Afred, even though that ain't her real name, telling this story like she time-tripping or something. Well, there's a good reason for that, homeboy. Like Afred herself telling us, I'm sorry there's so much pain in this story. I'm sorry it's in fragments, like a body caught in a crossfire or pulled apart by force. The structure of this novel is all jacked up, because that's exactly how Afred feeling. Broken, toe up, and confused as hell as to how everything in the world went to sh**. Sure, Atwood giving us explicit reasons everything's so twisted, like pollution and syphilis, but there's more to it than that, partner. Think of this book like a thought experiment, where Atwood taking common ignorant thoughts about women, like women should stay in that place, and show us where that kind of hateful thinking can lead us. When you got a whole society trying to put women in a box like that, it's gonna make them into empty, choiceless drones that don't serve no purpose other than popping out babies. You can peep that dehumanizing effect by the fact that Afred ain't even got a real name. Girl feeling like she already did. All the people I could love are dead or elsewhere. They might as well be nowhere, as I am for them. I too am a missing person. In the end, everything looks like it turned out all right. Or does it? We get some uppity professor yapping about Afred's story like it's the distant past. But on the real, he using the same kind of woman-hating logic, saying that her story probably ain't even legit. And that's the same whack-ass jive that turned the USA into Gilead. So truth is, this book just straight up depressing as hell. But chin up, homeboy, because that subscribe button is still there to cheer your ass up. So hit it and catch me next week, players. Peace. Hey, everyone. Thanks for watching. A great way you can help us keep making the show is by supporting our sponsors. Today, Thug Notes is sponsored by Audible, and they're going to give you a free audiobook just for being a fan of the show. Yeah, that's right, free. So head over to audible.com/thugnotes and get yourself a free audiobook. And if you're looking for a recommendation, we suggest The Hunger Games. If you like The Handmaid's Tale, Hunger Games also takes place in a dystopian future with a female protagonist. Plus, the last movie is coming out real soon, so be sure to catch up. Or you can get any book you want by going to Audible. Audible's got more than 180,000 of them. And they make it super easy. Just go to audible.com/thugnotes. Thanks for supporting our channel. Thanks for watching. Peace.